Hi and welcome back to my playthrough of Dark Horse, and I think this will be most likely the last episode I will play it to the bitter end today. One thing that I did do wrong during the last video was to discard this bank robbers event card, even though I opted for this second paragraph here. The event card itself still has to take place, so unfortunately I have to move this event thing here to the trader. The train robbers will get discarded and we will have the bank robbers now in effect, and this is really bad news. Apart from that, I also noticed that you're normally supposed to move this game and token at the start of a given round. Now I will do it this way. Not sure if it really makes a big difference, but I will try to play it right as of now. And I think without further ado, let's move into the next round. So I would move this now at the start of the turn, and then we would roll some dice. That's the six, which is the builder. Not sure if I like this. Then it's the red player, that's a seven, so this goes to the trader. Then it's the green player, that's also a seven, so we take the six, but the six is already taken, so green will not place any dice this round. And then it's back to us, and we roll a 10. That's not bad at all, to be honest, but I will not go for the sheriff. I think I will place the four here on the workroom. I will go with a six onto the builder. Therefore, I have to spend the engineer token, which is fine. Yeah, and this already ends the placement phase. So let's produce first. And again, I will go for wood and food accordingly. So in total, that's three additional resources. Before we trigger the builder, I will play the dirty deals. Now this means I have to send one of my dice to the jail. That's not really a problem, but this allows me to take the tycoon action for free, no dice required. This means I get another gold, and I'm also allowed to place a rail onto the board, and this is what I needed in order to place my city here. So, and now we will trigger the builder action, and again I have to spend one gold and four pieces of wood in order to build my third city. So here's the gold, here are four pieces of wood. So I have completed one of my objectives, and I also did manage to get one additional gold out of this, but still I have nine more to go, and this will really be pretty tough to beat, to be honest. I have no idea if I will be able to make it, because I really, again, I have to produce like crazy and I have to trade like crazy if I'm not extremely lucky getting whatever the right action cards, or maybe the tycoon action or so. Okay, but this was the end of the round. Now we start the next round. Now at the start of the round, I would move the game end token accordingly, and then it's time to roll some dice. Here's the, again, the builder. Okay, I think I don't need the builder anymore, to be honest. Then it's the red player, that's the six, so this goes to the work crew. This is really a pity, I needed the work crew, or at least some of those production spaces. Yeah, and this guy will be sent to the hired hand, to the pioneer, but I'm not so sure, to be honest, because we only take the highest die, and I think I would playing this kind of wrong during one of the last episodes to place the pioneer there. So I think in this case he will just go for the highest die and will place it here onto the hired hand. Hopefully I didn't do this wrong or mess it up, but I think this is the way how it's meant to be played. And because one of our dice is currently in jail, I'm only allowed to roll one single die. That's a four. And with a four, I think I'm going to produce. And again, I'm going to produce some lumber here. And because this is the extra action spot here, I get three pieces of lumber. Two for my resource hexes and one bonus token. Not too bad, but this was really, apart from that, a pretty useless turn, to be honest. But at least I'm getting my die back. This is again the end of the round. All the other players don't do anything, so let's start the next round and let's hope for something good. That's a one, so we will see or at least potentially an event, so that's not a bad thing, to be honest. Then it's the red player, that's a three and a one, so he goes for the politics action. I needed politics, to be honest, because I still have this private investor's card. But yeah, nothing I can do about it. Green player, that's the 9. He goes to the scout. And then it's me rolling 2 dice this time. Wow, again, very, very, very poor roll. So I think I really have to start trading. So I don't know. Let's place 1 die here onto the wood production space. And the 2 goes down here to the market. I can place any die there. And this allows me to get 1 gold for any 6 resources. This is really incredibly expensive. But on the other hand, the trader is not much better. Here it's a 5-1. Okay, let's resolve the actions. This time we start with the purple player. They always go first, so let's draw those 2 cards. And unfortunately, we are not lucky. No event card this round. This was really a pity. Let's produce some resources. Those are 2, because again, we still have 2 towns on wooden resource hexes. But overall, that's not too bad. All the other players don't do anything. So let's go to the market. So I pay 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 any resource, and therefore I gain 1 gold. I cannot do that more than once. Even if I would have whatever 18 or 12 resources, I still could only go for 1 exchange here, which is really, really limiting, but I have to live with that for now. So let's grab that piece of gold, which brings me to basically 3 gold tokens, because this is also worth a gold token, and I think I will trade it before this game comes to an end. But right now I'm still short of 7 additional tokens. Man, this is really close. I think these were all the actions, so let's end the round. Let's start the next one by moving the game end token. So, and again, we start with purple player, that's the 3. Politics again, not sure if I will ever use this, to be honest. And it's the red player, that's the 5. It's a rail baron. I think we don't need the rail baron anymore. Green player, that's a 4. Work crew, this kind of hurts. And then it's us, 4 and a 1. This is now tempting. Should I go for the pioneer? Or should I play it safe? So I could place the 4 here. This would give me 3 wooden resources, and I'm still allowed to place whatever on any other resource hexes. So I could still produce 1 piece of food. So in total, I would gain 4 resources. Or should I go for the pioneer action? Because in theory, I could really get an event, so 1 additional die and potential cool action card. No, I think, I'm feeling kind of lucky. Let's go for the pioneer. Let's draw 1 and 2 cards. So let's see what we get. Here we have the election. Receive 1 influence point or take the mayor action for free. No dice required, even if pin has been taken. That's not too bad. And no event. Pay 1 gold for 2 influence points. We would need it the other way around, to be honest. So we will totally discount this one and hold on to the election. And I basically have to play it right away. Receive 1 influence or take the mayor action for free. No dice required, even if it has been taken. I think that's a no-brainer. So let's go for the mayor action. This gives me the key, theoretically also 1 influence point, or worth 1 influence point by the end of the game, but not in this mode. I would gain 1 influence point, and I would also get any one of those resources. That's not too bad. And now I just got my first influence point, so I put my pawn back onto the influence track here. So hooray, we made our first point. And on top of this, I'm also allowed to grab a resource, and I go for 1 ore. Doesn't really matter. The election is getting discarded. Wasn't that powerful, but kind of okay, I guess. And this is already the end of the round. That's the case. Let's start the next one. And now we are already single digit here in respect to those rounds. That's really not good. Let's roll some dice and hope for something cool. Again, the 6th builder. No, I think we don't care about the builder anymore. Red player, that's 11. That's not good. We could use the broker. Then it's the green player, that's the 7. The trader, are you serious? Oh man, and then it's us. Let's see, a 4 and a 2. That's again, very, very lame, but I think I can produce now, and I think I have to do it, to be honest. So let's place the four here. Again, we are going for 3 units of wood. Yeah, that's the case. And with a second die, we will go to the market. Yeah, not really much I can do. Pretty boring round, I guess. So let's start the production. Again, I'm getting 3 units of lumber, and then we would move right over to the market, and there we would exchange 3, 4, 5, 6 resources against 1 piece of gold. Okay, this brings us to 4 gold pieces in total. Keep in mind, this is still worth a gold piece. And I'm thinking of using the private investors now. Lose 1 influence point, receive 1 free town and 1 free rail. Place both of the board immediately. Maybe I really should do that. So yeah, why not? Lose 1 influence point. And I guess I will place this town onto this base. I'm also allowed to place 1 rail. Doesn't really matter. I place this rail simply there. And again, this ends the round. Yeah, let's start the next one. Whew. And it's really getting closer and closer. Purple player starts the round. 5 rail baron. Do not really care about it. Red player, that's the work crew. I do care about this one. Now I could really use it well, to be honest. But yeah. That's the 2 hired hand. Yeah, not sure if I need it. Let's roll something good now. Again, I'm rolling really weak. What should I do about this? Wow, that's really awful roll. I think I really need an additional die, and my special ability allows me to use a natural 2 to go to the hired hand, even though it has been taken. So I get a bonus die for the next round. Well, that's a good thing. With a second die, I will just produce whatever, some resources. Let's go for some wood again. Then we can directly jump into the collection phase. So I get a bonus die, not too bad. Here I would produce 2 resources, but overall I'm not really sure if this needs, although this is 1 gold, this is not even 1, because still there are those bank robbers in town. We really have to get rid of those. Poof, I think I don't have a chance. Okay, but still I will play it to the bitter end, and so let's end the round. Let's start the next round. We move on to space number 7 here. So let's see. Again, the rail baron. Okay, that's not really a problem. Then it's the red player. 7. That's the trader. Again, I hate it. Okay. Then green player. An 8. It's the engineer. Engineer would also be pretty cool. And now I'm allowed at least to roll 3 dice. This is so unbelievable. Some of you might, or have watched some of my former playthroughs, and then if you did, you might have noticed that I'm really tending to roll very weakly, to be honest. So this is a very typical example for me on how badly I roll. Oh man. Okay, so in this case I think I will go for the pioneer action once more. I will place this single one onto the market action. This way I will at least make it halfway through the game during this round. But yeah, let's wait and see. Let's resolve the pioneer first. So let's hope for something good. So here we have dishonest trade. Trade any 2 of your resources for any 4 resources from the bank. That's not too bad. Okay, I take this one. And oh, we have another event. That's cool. Building a town costs 1 additional food. So this is a permanent event. It comes into play right away. This also means I gain my bonus die back. And on top of this, the bank robbers finally moved on. Whew. Okay, that's really, really good news in this case. Again, I get the bonus die and I have the dishonest trade here. And I think, why not? I'm still in my action phase, so I will play it right away. I would be last in the turn order, but again, I'm already last, so I cannot trade any 2 of my resources like those here for other resources from the bank. So in total, I basically doubled those, which isn't that bad because I still have one more action left. And this is down here at the market. So I have to pay 6 resources and therefore I'm getting another piece of gold. Not too bad, not too bad. And then it's already the end of the round. So let's move into round number 6 here. So again, we would start with a purple player. We would see a potential new event. That's not too bad. And then it would be the red player. That's the case. That's the 3 politics. It's fine, I guess. And it's the green player. That's a 3 or a 3. So we don't take either one. That's great, to be honest. And I'm still allowed to roll 3 dice because of a new event that came into the game. Let's see. And again, I'm rolling very, very badly. Oh, man. It's really, really unbelievable. Not sure what I will be doing with this because that's not even enough to go to the trader. This is really disappointing. Yeah, I think with a 4, I will go to the work crew. I will place a single one onto the food space here. And with the remaining die, I will go to the market once more. And I really don't know. Okay, that's really too damn expensive, but I have to live with that. First of all, we would trigger the pioneer action, so we would draw 2 cards. In the meantime, I had to reshuffle the deck, so here are the 2 cards. And unfortunately, we are not seeing any events, so I'm not getting any bonus dice. Really a pity. Then I would produce 2 pieces of food. Keep in mind, I already have 2 cities or towns on food resource hexes here. And then I will go for the work crew, and this gives me 2 more units of food because I decide to go for food and wood, and also I get 2 lumber for that. So overall, that's not too bad. I think I was getting 6 pieces of resources, which I will immediately use. Down at the market here, of course, I have to still add some of those. So we are 6 resources, and therefore I get another piece of gold. Hooray! So in total, this brings me now to 5 units here. And I think let's just trade this in. So let's go for another piece of gold. Let's exchange it against another of those, 3s here. So overall, I'm up to 6 of those gold pieces. I still need 4 more, but that's already the end of the round. So let's start the next one right away. And it's really getting closer and closer now. But yeah, let's roll some dice. So again, we would start with the yellow player. That's the hired hand. Then it's red. That's the 8, the engineer. Then we would roll the green player. That's the 10. So again, we have to roll if he goes for the mayor or the sheriff. In this case, he goes for the mayor. So we have to give our key to the city back. But yeah, we do not care about it that much. So let's roll our 2 dice. That's a 2 and a 2, and a pair means I get 1 of those wild die tokens back, and this is not too bad. But apart from that, I have no idea what I should be doing with this, to be honest. So again, it will be a pretty boring round, so I will place 1 die here, and yeah, the other die may need to go to the hired hand. I need additional dice. I'm pretty sure about that. I'm allowed to do that because of my special ability. Yeah, let's go into the production. And in this case, it's pretty easy. I'm just getting 2 pieces of wood. I might use it. And yeah, then it's the hired hand. So this gives me the additional die for the next round. And that's already the end of the round again. So let's start the next one. And let's hope for something good. That's the 4 work crew. Ooh, this hurts. This really hurts. It's gonna be the scout. I don't really care about the scout, I think, at least. And here we have the 10. Again, we have to roll the die, but to be honest, I really don't care that much anymore. But nevertheless, roll the die. I return the mayor here. So again, someone is going for the mayor action. Then it's us. We are allowed to roll 3 dice because we went to the higher hand last round. Slightly better, but not overly powerful as well. So I think I have to go to the Pioneer. I really have to hope for some cool action card. So let's place those dice here. And I think with those, I want to produce. No, I think I will place it onto the market once more. This brings me at least a little bit closer to my goal. So again, let's do the collection phase. Let's draw our two cards. And again, we have bad news. The bank robbers are back. So again, trading is more expensive, but I think I didn't go there one single time doing this playthrough, to be honest. So again, I could go for this gold here, so I really have to think about it. And the other action card would be Snake Eyes. Roll a die for each wild die token you discard. I have one. I could gain one gold, but here I get an auto gold, to be honest, and I get additional gold this round. I think I have to go there, but I would lose my bonus die, but I would get two gold pieces this round. I think this is what I have to do. So I will discard the Snake Eyes, and yeah, I will go for this trader action here. Again, now we will remember it goes into play. Unfortunately, I have to send all of my dice to jail, but of course I'm still allowed to trigger my market action down there. But still, I'm allowed to get one gold token because of those bank robbers here, but I also have to move the big event token. The drought is gone. Let's put the bank robbers into play once more, and then I will trigger the market action here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and again I'm getting one piece of gold for that. Yeah, this brings me to 8 units of gold. So it's really a very close call, but unfortunately I'm nearly out of resources. So this food token is my only resource left, and I will completely miss out the next round. So yeah, let's end this one and move into the next round. I will basically only roll the die to see if there will be a Pioneer action. So I'm not really counting on this. Guess what? It's the one. Okay, that's pretty much everything I have to roll. All the other actions really do not matter at all. So let's roll, solve it right away. So an action card and another action card. Again, I'm not lucky. I was really hoping for an event. So first of all, I would get a bonus die, and of course the event token would move, but of course I'm not lucky. So let's just get rid of those. Let's end the round. Let's release my dice, and then let's start the next round. And yeah, I think, to be honest, I have no chance. I really have to be incredibly lucky, but I might gain one additional one, but I only have this and the next round left in order to win this game. Oh man, this is disappointing, but yeah, let's wait and see. So again, we would start with a purple pair. And again, an event, or let's say a Pioneer action. I was really hoping for a Pioneer, but let's see. That's red. It goes to the work crew. Okay, now I'm really out of the game, I guess. Let's see, that's the 5. I don't care about the Rail Baron anymore. Let's roll our dice. If I would roll a 12 or an 11 now, I'm still in the game. But yeah, see for yourself. I could go for the Broker because I could use my wild die in order to increase this to a 5. And yeah, this is what I will do. Okay, we are still a part of this game. Awesome. So let's take this. This will be a virtual 11 basically. And this allows me to go to the Broker. Hooray. So this gives me another one of those stock tokens here. And this stock token is worth one gold piece. Awesome. But first of all, let's resolve the Pioneer action here. So again, we would see 2 of those cards. So let's see, private investors, lose one influence point. That's okay. I think I had this before. And an event, jailbreak. So I would gain a bonus die for the next round. Wow, that's really awesome. And then, yeah, the sheriff action is now reduced cost. But what's more important, because of this jailbreak, we would also get rid of the bank robbers. So they decided to flee as well. So let's take this event token and place it onto the sheriff space here. So that's the jailbreak. Awesome, awesome, awesome. And then we will trigger the broker here. This gives me one of those stock certificates, and I will immediately exchange it into one piece of gold. I'm now one unit short. Can you believe this? But the good thing is I'm allowed to get the bonus die because of the new permanent event card. So next, and I think the last round, I would be able to roll all three of my dice. And if I would manage to roll a 12 or an 11 somehow, yeah, I may be able to win this game. Woohoo! Let's see. Yeah, I think, yeah, let's end this round. Let's start the next one. So this is the last round. So this is how the rules, and to be honest, I have not counted myself, but the rules clearly say when this one moves onto the one spot, in this case, I would trigger the final round of the game. So let's do that, and let's hope for something good. First purple player again, an event. I was really hoping to go there. Let's see. Then red. Red goes to the engineer. I think I don't need the engineer anymore. And it's the green player. No! Oh, come on. If I now would roll a 12, I would be toast because of this roll. Okay, we have to place those green dice onto the tycoon space. So one of the two action spaces now just vanished into thin air. Oh man, can you believe it? Yeah, and then it's the final roll. Let's see what we get. It's the 11. Can you believe that? That's the either or. Oh man, I'm extremely lucky, you guys. So whatever I do, I really don't care about it at all. So I would place this one here, for example, onto production space. So let's do that right away. Let's produce some, I don't know, wood. One last time, let's take this 11. Let's place it onto the broker. I don't have to resolve anything else in theory, but let's go for the pioneer one last time. And here we simply see two action cards. So let's just get rid of it. We don't produce. I really don't care about it at all. Let's dive directly into the New York Stock Exchange. Let's get one of these certificates and read it again. Exchange for three resources or one gold at any time as needed. And now I really need it. And yeah, this gives me the final piece of gold. I need it in order to win this game. Wow, what a close call. To be honest, I'm not so sure if I should have had in this another round from now on, but I really don't care at all. I just won this game. Very close call, but absolutely thrilling exercise. I can understand that the last couple of rounds seemed a little bit dull, so I only produced and whatever went to the markets. And I think this is because of the scenario I went for. Maybe for the next time I might consider doing something else. Not so sure. I'm happy. And I still hope you enjoyed my little playthrough of Dark Horse here. I really hope I haven't made too many mistakes here. Now it's too late anyway to repair those. There won't be another episode, but if you find something, I will try to leave a comment, of course. And yeah, I cannot express enough how much I love this game. It's really, really one of my favorite games of all times. Really, I enjoyed a big deal. After playing this solo variant, I think it's working pretty well, to be honest. But yeah, I certainly enjoyed more playing it the multiplayer, where there's really much more going on. You're really doing much more of those take that actions, and especially with the expansions, you're introducing a lot of interesting additional stuff. Nevertheless, I really hope you enjoyed it. Hope to see you soon in one of my next videos. And yeah, until then, bye bye.